Hi friends, welcome back to my channel. I'm Archana from Learning with Play, and today I am back with a activity notebook for a 4-year-old. This was requested by a lot of parents when I had posted the activity notebook for 5-year-olds. So now this activity notebook is purely inspired by Divyanka Pawar, because when I started learning activities with my daughter, and she is one of my inspirations, so this notebook is truly inspired by her. And now for a maths notebook, this is a purely a maths notebook, a numbers notebook, which has numbers from 1 to 20. Now some of the activities help recognition of the numbers, some of the activities help ordering of the numbers, and patterning activities. So all of the activities are included here, including shapes. So now this is purely a fun learning notebook for her, because we never stressed too much on writing or too much on learning activities, but since she is very good with numbers, she used to enjoy this notebook thoroughly whenever she did not want to do any other activities, or whenever she did not want to play or do some other stuff, she would always say, "Mama, I want to do patterns." She used to call this a pattern notebook, and she used to enjoy doing this notebook. So and also people who have still not subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe to my channel, like and share it with your friends and family, and please turn the bell notification icon on so that you receive a notification as soon as I upload a new video. And for the other activities that are already there on my channel, if you wish to buy them, I have shared my WhatsApp number in the description box below. You can get in touch with me on my WhatsApp number, and I also share a lot of fun learning activities on my Insta and FB pages, so do check them out. The links have also have been shared in the description box below. So without wasting much of the time, let's start. Okay, so this is the activity notebook. Now this is some pre-writing strokes that we had done. Okay, some more pre-writing strokes, and these are the curves. Okay, this is number sequencing from 1 to 10. Number sequencing is a very important activity or a very important part of the math learning activity, or in fact any kind of activity, because sequencing helps for a lot of other activities, like before and after numbers. Then you have greater than or less than numbers, and a lot of such activities. So make sure your kid is very well versed with the sequencing of the activities. Okay. Now this book, you will see a lot of repetitions. We had done only numbers from 1 to 20, but initially we started with 1 to 10. So you will see a lot of repetition of activities, but repetition is the key here, because kids learn through repetition. The more they do the activity, the well-versed they get. Now initially, once they know how to do it with 1 to 10 numbers, it becomes easier for them to do the 11 to 20 numbers and the greater numbers. So try and do more repetition of the activities. Okay, now this is matching the number. This helps for number recognition. It's a good number recognition activity. Then here they have to count and match the number. Next activity is matching the shapes. Now here they have to circle the smallest object. I had asked her to circle the smallest object, so she needs to find out which is the smallest object and circle it. I've given her 3 dots here, and then she has to make the shape, and then she has to even name the shape. She will obviously not write the shape, because we were not yet into writing that time. And this notebook is like a year back we have done, because she is now 5, and we had made this notebook when she was 4. So okay, so she has to match the numbers. So you see all the activities are already done, and we finished this book completely. Okay, now here this is circle the number, number 7, the number 9, number 6. I've randomly given her numbers, and I randomly placed the numbers. So this is a good number recognition activity. Then we have circled the biggest picture. We'll find the biggest picture and then circle it. then she has to count and circle the correct number. So she will first count how many triangles are there, how many droplets are there. Then I have given her two options. She has to select which one is the correct option and circle it. Okay, so here also she has to first recognize the numbers. Then again, she has to match the quantity. So first she will count the quantity on one side, then she has to remember the quantity that she's counted on this side, and then count the same quantity on this side and then match. Now this is circle all the triangles, this circle all the rectangles. We were doing shape recognition also. Now this is I have placed the dots according to the dice, and she has to find out which number belongs to how many dots belong to which number. Yeah, so she has to count the dots and match the numbers. Here are some random pattern activities. They need to find out the same patterns and match them. A good, very good visual discrimination activity as well. Now these are some random tracing lines where she needs to trace the lines given. A good pre-writing activity. Again, the dice activity. Now here again we have the number recognition activity where she has to circle the given number. We have a matching activity, then we have a dot to dot activity. Now here I have given her the shapes. I have drawn random objects, and then she has to find out which which shapes are there in this object, and then accordingly match it on the other side. So if she sees two circles here, she will find two circles, and then she has to match. These are some random patterns again. Now this is a grid. I had given her a 4x4 grid. I had drawn only the dots on this side, and I had drawn the patterns here. I hope you can see the patterns. Okay, now she needs to find out where the patterns start from, which place the patterns start from, and then accordingly follow the grid on this side. It is not easy for a 4-year-old to do this activity. Not all kids might want to do the activity, so if your kid is not interested, please do not force. In fact, for any activity, I would say is if the child is not showing interest, leave the activity for some time and then redo it again after a few days. Okay, because once the child is not showing interest, do not force them, otherwise they gradually lose interest. So do not force them for any kind of activity. If they readily do the activity, well and good. Now this is count the number of shapes and write down. So here I have drawn random shapes, and then I have given her to write the shapes. How many shapes? Now this is a pattern activity. Here I have given her AB patterns and AABB patterns. I have introduced to her this for the first time, and she was good. She could recognize the patterns and she could do the activity well. So we did this activity. Now we've repeated this activity a number of times in this book itself. So most of the activities are repeated once we are done with 1 to 10 numbers. Okay. Now this is again copy the pattern but in a different way. I have given her this. I have given her only the dots, and she needs to make the same pattern with the dots. Some more. Now this is left and right concept. Now when you are introducing or when you want to introduce coding to the kids, it is very important they understand the left and right concept. Obviously in day-to-day life also they have to understand the concept, but this is just an introduction to the left and right stuff. So here she has to circle the left object, and here she has to circle the right object. Now this is half and half matching, where I have drawn half shapes this side and half shapes this side, and then she has to match accordingly. Now this is count the numbers or color the numbers, color the circles in fact. So she will read the number, recognize the number, and color the dots accordingly. And this is again counting the number of scoops and writing the number here. So how many scoops is there? Scoops are there, she will count and then she will write it here. Now this is before and after numbers. We had not done numbers, or we were not thorough with our sequencing at that point of time. So we had skipped the before and after numbers for a while, and she couldn't understand the point, the concept at that time, and I had not even introduced the number line at that time. So at that point of time we skipped these two activities, and later when she was comfortable we came back to the activities and finished them. Okay, now this is missing numbers, and this is again a very important step in number sequencing. Okay, this is the middle number. Now here we started with numbers 11 to 20. So now you will see all of the activities are the same activities that we did here before, but only the patterns or the numbers or the sequence is going to change here now. Now this is a grid that I introduced to her. I had made the box and I had given her the circles here, and she had to make the circles exactly in the same positions as given in this squares. Okay, now this is a pattern matching activity. She loves this pattern matching activity. So initially they have to be very careful. They have to see where the circle comes, triangle and the rectangle or the square, and then they accordingly match. Now this is a coding activity, just the first step in coding. I had given her a circle, a triangle and a square, and I have given the numbers to the circle, triangle and square, and here I have made entire box with the circle, triangle and square. Now she needs to decode this, what does the circle represent, and she needs to write it here below. So she used to write it here, and initially it is difficult for them, so you need to make them understand the activity, but gradually with practice they can do the activity. Now here again, the since we started with numbers 11 to 20, here we have circle 12s and circle 16s. Then again a pre-writing activity, then again a coding activity. As I said, you will all see repetitions now, except that a few patterns might change or a few patterning activities might change. Other than that, everything is going to be similar. Now here, instead of just the circles, I have introduced the triangles also. She was not comfortable drawing the shapes at that point of time also. So you can see how randomly she's drawn the shapes. Okay. This is again before and after, which we did once she was thorough with the sequencing and everything. But the book, I had made it earlier. So we skipped those pages then. Okay. Now here you can see the patterns. I keep changing patterns. How she has to do, or here the shapes I keep changing, but the activity, the concept remains the same. Here you can see the concept is still the same. She just needs to match accordingly. Here this you can see 11 to 20 dot to dots. Then we did a few pre-writing again. So the activities now here will keep changing. Now here I've given her sequence, writing numbers from 11 to 20 in the sequence, because it is a very important part of the math program. Okay, now this is the sequencing, the patterning activity again. She used to call this a pattern notebook. Whenever she did not want to do any activity or did not want to play, she used to always come to me and say, "Mama, I want to do patterns." This is what she used to call the book. Okay, now here, if you can see, I've changed the numbers here, 4, 5 and 6. So she will accordingly write the numbers here in the code. Rest of the activities remain the same. The concept remains the same, just the patterns or something will change, nothing much. Okay, in case you have any doubts regarding any activity or regarding the activity notebook, please feel free to comment in the comment, and I will surely get back to you on this. Thank you.